face.
Hey. All right, let's get through the sponsors real quick. I'm sweating. As you could tell, there is no titty. It's just boy boy today. So, but well, it's okay. We got four guys. So it should be, not better, but more conversation, maybe, hopefully. I don't know.
Rest in peace, Titty.
Yeah, he'll be back. He's on vacation, or not vacation. He's working right now. He'll be gone.
Working vacation.
He's with a bunch of dudes. He'll be gone for, he'll be gone for like a month or two. So depending on how his job goes. But let's get through the sponsors. AFC, Alaska Fighting Championship. It's not for like another couple months, I think, until they're going to be starting fights up again. But go see those guys. Go check out AlaskaFightingChampionship.com. Thank you, Capo's Beard Oil, for he couldn't make it. He was actually supposed to be a guest on today. These fine gentlemen stepped up and decided to throw in.
Answered the call.
That's right. It was rad. You should, man. Have you seen, do you know Capo? Have you seen this guy?
I think I saw him through your post. Yeah.
Yeah, his beard's like this big. Yeah. He looks like he's wearing a Spartan helmet without the helmet.
He's a dude who's like could lift a car over his
head,
right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So literally. Yeah.
Probably good. Depending on the car.
He's got like someone's not doing so good in his family. So it's totally understandable. If he said he just didn't want to hang out, it's kind of whatever. But so thank you, Capo. Also thank you, Josh. Alaska Audio Works. Go look at AlaskaAudioWorks.com. Look him up on Facebook. He's the one that does this intro. I think it already played. and I think that's... Oh, Arctic Chiropractic. Let's not forget East 500 Benson.
Solid.
Caleb Craig. He's jacked. Did you see that episode? Mm. Oh, yeah. I had a shot of him in his underwear doing this. And he's just like ripped up, oiled, and he's got tats everywhere.
You just like interviewing jacked people.
Whoa, I do. And once again, I'm still the fattest guy on the show.
What's that about?
What's
that about, Ricky?
He's hot. You know him? You met him?
Did I? When? I don't think I have. I saw him like you guys showed me. Like he's like,
you
bro,
this showed him
like,
his muscles.
Yeah.
He's owner and operator of Arctic Chiropractic, like in Anchorage, and he's like the only doctor. Are they doctors? I guess so. Dr. Caleb Craig is what we call him. He's tatted from like here down to here, and then he just got another one from here to here, and he's not stopping. He sat in the seat for 9 hours the first day and then 5 hours the second day.
Dang.
I was like, dude.
So he's just a champion.
He is. Wow. When we got our tattoos, did you see our matching tattoos?
We have matching tattoos,
Check it out.
Show that to the camera.
I don't know.
Da-da-da.
Yeah, sweet.
Yeah.
I'm going to tell you again.
Yeah, we have the same guitar, different colors, but same model. ESP, was it EC-1000, whatever. So
I'm matching tattoos with people.
Do you?
Yeah.
Not, but by accident or like you went and got them?
No, I've got a hammer right here.
Thor's. Let me see.
Boom.
Oh, that's sweet. That's like the bro.
It's a bro
squad. Yeah.
It's like if people ask about it. I'm like, it's just friendship tattoo. Sure, sure. I don't want to go into the actual like lameness of it because it's based off of Call of Duty.
Right. Yeah, so. Is that your clan name or whatever?
It was like Call of Duty. I don't know which one, but they had this
57
gun called the Hammer, H-A-M-M-R, and it was just like the most bullets and the most power. And so we would go and just fill it up and just spray and pray everywhere.
all the time.
And we're like, yeah, it was scholarship Hammer Bros, you know, we made a clan and then it became like the AK Hammer Bros, like this weird thing.
I wasn't allowed to play with them.
And then you guys invited me.
I just never got on.
And then it was like, we should get tattoos. It sounds like the best idea.
Next step, tattoos.
The best idea. I guess I have two tattoos I share with people. So we've got the guitar tattoo, me and Ricky. Bros for life. I've also, my buddy Kyle Redding, he got a No Sleeper tattoo. I got on my knee. We didn't get it together, but like he got it later on his calf.
Well, yours isn't. Yours is on your knee.
Yeah. But yours he got the same thing, just on his calf. That emblem. So. Yeah.
Is that the Call of Duty? Is that the one with the tomahawks?
Oh man.
Because like you know
that was a Black Ops.
It was before
the very first one.
It was before Ghosts. Before Ghosts.
But yeah, I didn't. I don't know. I got tired of them.
Yeah, I'm just lost on where we at Call of Duty. Four.
Well, Ghosts. Ghosts, I like five. Ghosts. And then after Ghosts, I was like, once they start meddling in the future, I was like,
nah. That's why I'm excited for Battlefield. Yeah. Battlefield 1. All back World War 1. Has there ever been a World War 1 game like that? Not that I know of.
World War II just gets all the attention, man.
Well,
poor World War I. Just everyone, it's just the poor forgotten stepchild of World War
I. I really don't know anything about World War I.
Oh, my gosh.
It was just a giant, like, clusterfuck.
Yeah.
Well, just honestly, it's terrible. It's the worst thing. It's really depressing to read about it. There's just, like, no rhyme or reason. Just it's terrible.
Prop planes aren't as cool as, like, jets,
yeah,
and stuff like that.
You can, take like pot pins down with a potato, though. Like.
A potato with some C4 in it.
Yeah. They literally, like, if they ran out of bullets, they just like pull out a pistol and just like go at it with each other, you know.
They had some pretty BA weapons in the game. I don't know if you've seen any of the gameplay or whatnot, but yeah, it looks pretty cool.
Mm.
And the tanks, too, they're like all from like that Indiana Jones movie, which one, the Last Crusade,
yeah,
when like he like. Goes that German dude goes down over the cliff in it. Yeah, so that's cool. I mean, I don't know, the preview made it look really cool.
Yeah,
but and you could be in a blimp
and what? Like that, dude, blimps, that like blimps as a military device. I can't even believe that happened.
I know, right?
They literally, they drop bombs out of blimps.
One stray bullet. Ting.
The balls on those people, dude. That is
huge.
That is
huevos.
Something
the
else.
The blimps
dude.
Were for nighttime, right? Where they're just like.
Yeah, I believe so. And they were real quiet. Maybe. So, I mean. Yeah. And they were high enough up. I mean, it's not like they were like right over
it's
the ground.
It's like, let's inflate a giant
balloon.
Ball of gas.
Full of gas.
And just float and drop bombs over the enemy. This can't go wrong.
You know, we're
can't
sitting here wrong. Talking about. I bet you he knows a lot about World War One. You know, I didn't even introduce our guests.
Yeah, you didn't introduce any of us, Ricky.
Well, you're not a guest right now. You're co-hosting because Titty's out, so you're Titty too.
No, that's
Mason.
I'm Mason.
This is Mason Van House. This is Kyle Harrington. Almost had Redding and Mike Avakovich. And I tell you what's crazy because we got like the three like best guitar players in Alaska in the same room. Is amazing. And I know it got really quiet because people are like, well,
top 10.
No, I'd have to say right at the top. At the very
I'd say
top.
My buddy Argel, shout out. Super good.
RJ?
Yeah. No, Argel. He plays with Old Hounds. Oh my God. So good. The kid, he's like 24. Like he shreds me to death. Mike can take him though. Mike's probably better.
I'm out of practice.
He's out of practice until
Mike,
he picks one up and goes, oh yeah.
Yeah, Mike in his prime, definitely. But Argel's freaking good. Kyle's freaking good.
Kyle's
smooth. Kyle's just like a...
Not only smooth, but it's like every single person that I've talked to that's had a lesson from Kyle, they're like, that guy, if you ask him to learn a song, he'll learn it that night and then teach me the next day. I'm like, that is crazy. That's amazing. That's amazing talent.
Or on the spot.
Or on...
You know, with pretty much...
Yeah.
Usually well, with things nowadays.
Yeah, with the smartphones.
Well, the internet just
has
every
song. Well, no, I was just
going
to say music now.
Oh.
It's pretty easy.
Oh, yeah.
People get disappointed when, you know, it's like 4.5 chords, basically, and it's the whole song, and they're like, really? That's the whole song?
Well, what
like,
kind of songs are you teaching them?
Whatever they ask.
About 4 or 5. Okay, so you're telling me that nobody picks. Well, I guess Slayer's not nowadays.
No, wait, were
you talking like top 40 Slayer. Or something?
Oh yeah, yeah.
You have some pop
some
or
Taylor
something?
Swift songs.
Yeah. What?
I
love Taylor Swift.
Well, I have female students.
Oh yeah,
enjoy Taylor Swift. I even have one student this poor kid where it's like his first day and he's like 8 or something and he's really shy and his mom's like, so what kind of? I was like, what kind of music you like? And he's just kind of like.
He's like, what's music?
I like cut myself.
And no, he was just embarrassing.
Oh,
and his mom's sitting there, and he's like, well, tell him what you like. And he's like, I don't know. And she's like, do you want me to tell him? And he's like, yes, because I'm embarrassed.
Oh.
and she's like, well, he likes Taylor Swift.
Respect. Hey, good pop music is good pop music. Don't
you like what you like?
Yeah. I mean. That if you like a girl singing to you, cool.
Yeah, right. Like,
hey, Paul Gilbert actually is a big pop music fan.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, huge.
That's crazy because that's like, seems like so far left field from,
well,
it
remember,
seems.
You remember years ago when you bought his first...
yeah, up in there. Eat it.
Eat that thing.
Yeah.
Remember that? Remember years ago when you bought his first solo album?
Yeah,
it was like nothing like
nothing.
We
yeah,
expected.
It was way out left field.
Yeah, it was just all singer songwriter stuff. It wasn't like any kind
of really
or anything. Yeah,
he sings like
yeah.
Oh, I never heard him sing.
Yeah,
he has some really weird stuff. I mean, weird stuff. Almost like I mean, not as weird as what's his name? George Lynch.
Oh, yeah.
When he came out with, do you know who that is?
Yeah.
The Wicked Sensation, right?
Mm. The Lynch Mob? I've heard of him. I can't say I've like, I can tell you any of his songs. I followed some Paul Gilbert, though.
Yeah.
Who did he play with? Like he was a whole, Mr. you know, Mr. Guitar
Big.
Institute.
Mr. Big, Razor X,
yeah.
Okay.
Paul
okay.
Gilbert.
He's an
guitar
Andy.
Hero.
Yeah,
I have a
seriously.
Signed poster of him on my wall. And it says, like, Mr. Big on it. All my students are like,
who's that?
Who's Mr. Big? Mr. Big is a band that you should listen to because Billy Sheehan and Willie on the bass.
Oh, my gosh.
Super group.
I love watching that one concert that they have from 80-something or whatever, and the first thing that happens is, like, Billy Sheehan runs out and does, like, a split on the stage, like, jumps out and does the splits, and he's like,
Dude, the showmanship like in the 80s was pretty ridiculous. Have you seen like the Van Halen like whatever jump DVD? It's like 1985 or something. With like Sammy Hagar's doing splits like everywhere. Freaking Van Halen's jumping around doing jumping jacks, freaking windmills and stuff.
And guess what?
Wow, you guys
held the music too.
Oh, dude, there's no. I mean, he had a bass solo.
Oh,
what's
I know.
His face? Was it Mike?
Yeah.
He had a bass though, and he's like running around working the crowd. I'm like,
what about the drums though? Never ever gave credit to the drums.
They had a drum solo too. I remember the Van Halen live dude. They had a solo of everything. I think Sammy Hagar did like a guitar solo.
Yeah, he kept time.
Because he can play too.
Hey, a lot of people nowadays have to play with click tracks. They didn't have those back then.
Yeah. What's
you had to keep time.
Yeah, you had to learn how to actually. Dude, hit on time.
Right, we can quantize all that shit now.
Yeah.
It's awesome.
We got so much shit for playing tracks during our music for Faceless and the
you
Lost Concept.
You had tracks?
Yeah.
That's
well,
I remember that.
We had tracks because...
Just like kind of intro?
Yeah,
tracks?
It wasn't anything that went through the... It was like for like the...
I don't remember.
Mainly the intro for like the main intro.
Song, yeah.
And then like one or two songs had like... It was like, woo, man, it's getting creepy in here.
I'm running away.
Yeah.
No matter what they say. Hey, that's a good song.
Steel Panther actually uses tracks.
Ooh, yeah.
Yeah, well, they have to.
I mean, everybody does now. Everybody does now.
Yeah. They have to for all the girls in the back going, I showed, it was so funny. We had this drinking sesh with our pastor. And what wasn't a drinking sesh? He brews beer.
It was a brew sesh.
Brew sesh,
nice. Which is code for drink. We enjoy some of his home brews.
Yeah, which is really good. And I was like, they started talking about Richard Cheese. Have you ever heard that?
Oh yeah.
He's like, hey, crazy motherfucker.
Toxicity.
Yeah. And I was like, have you guys ever heard Steel Panther? And everybody was like, no. Oh. I think except for you. And I was like.
I think you showed me before.
I was like,
oh God.
I was like, check this out. Boonk. And like a bunch of people from the church are sitting in the garage and it's like,
oh, no.
Meet me down at the glory hole. I was like, isn't this great?
The worst lyrics of all time.
And Brian was just like, oh man, that is really funny and really bad at the same time. maybe I shouldn't speak for him. But yeah.
No, he hated it.
I bet you he did.
Condemned it.
He did.
Burned it.
Yeah. He probably went in the back and whipped himself a couple times. I have to say that so people know that it wasn't okay to listen to.
No.
And I posted one. They did this. Not. Their covers are amazing. What was the one they did of... oh, crap. They did... They only have like a couple covers. Alva Aldo?
You got me, son.
Is this English?
Yeah, it is. It's Aldo... I can't remember the name of the song. Dang it. Now I can't even remember how it goes because I got put on the spot, but I can't remember. Dang it.
I like watching.
Yeah, look it up.
Steel Panther.
Yeah. They did this. Alda Alvo? Is that how you say it? No. I can't remember. Anyways, I posted one of their songs of their covers and it was amazing. And like a bunch of people gone there was like, whoa, that is the raddest cover I've ever heard. Who is it? And I wouldn't tell anybody. People were texting me. Hey, who is that? I'm not going to tell these people. I mean. You know, they go look up Steel Panther, and they're like, oh, this guy likes Steel Panther.
Oh, got reputation.
Well, no, not really. They see this, it kind of goes out the window.
Yeah.
I think I had some family members try to watch, like, the first couple episodes, and Christopher Titty, my co-host.
Where
is rest in peace.
House.
Yeah, we're in his house. Yeah, rest in peace. He's like, F-D, F, 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 suck my balls. So, like, so
you get a gist for the... What's going on pretty early on. Yeah.
Yeah. So like a majority of the people that like started watching them were like, I'm out.
Yeah.
Whatever. it doesn't, that kind of, I don't know. I'm not like, I try not to like overuse.
Yeah.
Sure. And I don't use it for the sake of just using it. But you don't then again,
like censor yourself. Either.
I don't have a problem with it because it's a little bit different nowadays than it was back in the day.
Well, what does it mean? Oh,
yeah. Did you find it?
They couldn't find it. No.
What? Oh, okay. Did you look up Panther cover? Steel Panther cover?
Well, I have all three. Unless they have a fourth album out that I'm not.
No, it's not on one of their albums.
It's a B-side.
Yeah.
Deep cut.
Deep cut. Yeah.
Deep track. Deep
track. It goes deep. But anyways, it's like there's different meanings for, like, I know when somebody comes in the room, they're like, "What's up, motherfuckers?" I mean, it's different.
It's contextual.
I mean, well, yeah, it's going to be the same thing. And if you're saying like, "Hey, mother jammers," or "frack that," or I mean, it's like, whatever, like BSG.
That's weird. I love
fracking. Battlestar Galactica.
You weren't here, but we talked about that before, about a mutual friend of ours would go, he'd be at work. Kind of blew it there. Anyways, but he'd go, he'd be sitting there.
Who is this guy?
I'm not going to say.
Okay.
He'd be sitting there clicking or whatever and he'd go, "Mother trucker." And he meant it, his face. "Mother trucker." And he'd throw. And yeah. I walked up. I said, why don't you just say motherfucker? And he goes, "Because I don't cuss." And I'm like,
Well, your heart's cussing.
Yeah.
Exactly.
I was like, what's the difference? You're trading one word for another.
Motherfucker in like a, you know, friendly, like inviting way than like to yell mother trucker pissed off at somebody. It's all about the intent.
It's intent.
Context.
Yeah, for sure. And it's like, I feel real bad because like my dad, you know, my dad's real old school.
Yeah.
And he knows a lot of people take like liberty with like saying certain things or whatever like that. But we're watching the fights and Nate Diaz. You probably don't watch him, but Nate Diaz like won his fight against Conor McGregor, and at the end they're like, "How do you feel?" And he's like, "Yeah, motherfucker, yeah." And I like looked over at my dad, and he's like, "Oh," and I was like, It doesn't mean I'm gonna stick it in your mouth. It doesn't mean that. It
doesn't mean that anymore.
At this point, it just means yeah.
Actually, it's very healthy.
Sticking it in your mouth. Whoa. Wait. We went sideways.
Left field. I'm sorry. I just meant like actually, you know, cussing, swearing.
It's a release.
It's a release.
Release stress.
Release stress.
Yeah. I've heard that.
Like you said, it's all intent behind the word. Yeah. You could say anything you want as long as you say, "God bless their heart."
Kelly Clarkson.
You know, "Oh, Martha, she's such a bitch. God bless her heart." See, you could say anything.
Fucking whore.
Yeah, "God bless her heart." Or God bless her. Yeah, "God bless her heart." You can say anything you want as long as you follow it up with that. Did you find it?
No.
Give me your phone.
Here.
I do have a phone.
You do have a phone. I got the list of all their covers, too.
And another thing, too, is because when Chris is not here.
Everybody's going to get on their phone.
That's okay. When Chris isn't here. Or when Chris is here, my computer's used, and that thing is used for, you know, looking stuff up and whatnot. And now we can't do that. Now we just have to do the phone.
Yeah.
What's up with that?
This is even on.
What is it? It won't be on.
The iPad. Not even charged up.
Don't let me have dead air, man. Come on, Goose. Oops.
Goose!
I can't remember what we were talking about before Steel Panther, but it was about 80s or something. Yeah, we kind of got off.
It's always gonna go
back. The quality of it.
It's always gonna go back to things were better back then.
They were.
Now music, but well, there's probably some truth to that. So I'm just saying. I was thinking today. Well, I was just like, well, who's gonna take the reins as like the next like major big bands? Like, there's Metallica, and Metallica has reigned as like, you know.
The metal band.
Yeah, and then who's going to be it, you know? Well, they have for a while. I mean, well, but who's it now?
They've had a number of failures for albums for...
Oh, sure.
Maiden, they're the name. Okay, well, Maiden
actually
never been on the radio. Well, yeah, but I'm just talking about just like...
Mainstream, everybody
still,
knows?
Still putting out good stuff here and there and still having a name, like who's going to be the go-to?
There's a lot of bands out right now that younger generations are listening to in order to get that, which is, I don't know, name any one of the...
Avenged Sevenfold.
No. Slap Your Mother. That's ridiculous.
Oh, they are.
That is, who? They are?
Yeah.
They are the raddest?
No, well, you're talking about generations listening to it.
Well, I know, but it's just...
But nobody can come up with anything after like, oh, these guys, that's it.
Right, that's the new band.
Oh, what do you want us to do? Metallica.
Well, the problem is there's too many.
Peppers. All these guys are like, well, I'm pushing my late 50s or something.
Memphis Mayfire or Bless the Fall or any of those guys.
Yeah, but they're not going to achieve that. No, that status.
The status.
Oh, yeah.
I don't think you can. Can you achieve that?
Yeah,
status.
I don't know.
I don't think you can anymore.
I don't know.
Young kids aren't into, you know, long hair and sick licks. They're into, you know, booty shaking, you know, you know,
that electronic music,
thong sloppy thong shaking. Yeah, yeah, I don't know. That's my kids don't listen to. They like metal, but
there's no real like.
The same
enthusiasm.
He's good.
For bands, like I remember as a kid, you know, when growing up, whenever this is long before internet, if you could imagine a world without internet.
Oh yeah, I was there. It sucked.
Yeah, I was there. It was awesome.
Actually, it was good. it was awesome.
Actually, you know, and you had record stores, and you know, when a band put out a new album, we're all excited. You don't get that no more,
right?
You know, you're not like, oh, you know, so and so just put out a new album. We got to go get it. You know. No.
Well, there's new stuff coming at these kids 24/7. They're the microwave generation. I fall into the same thing. I put one thing down or one song or one show, I'm immediately looking for the next. I don't sit around and enjoy it because back then it was few and far between.
Yeah.
You actually had one have talent.
Mm-hmm.
You couldn't have all these producers behind you, you know, yeah, writing your stuff and actually, I mean, yeah, they owned it because of, you know, people signing and whatnot, but it's, I don't know. We're in this cookie cutter thing.
Yeah.
You know, people hear one good thing, they try to emulate it.
I forgot the name of the what's his name? But anyway, he predicted back in the, even in the 60s, that this was back in the 60s, eventually he said within 40 to 50 years, he said music would lose its value.
Hmm.
You know.
Just because it's too easily accessed.
Well, in his case, he said it would become so overly saturated. He didn't really say why, but you know, of course, technology became so accessible. I mean, it's kind of a dream come true for us because I remember back when, you know, you were spending at least just to get a measly 4-track recorder.
Oh, yeah.
You know, with cassette.
Oh yeah.
Started like $700-$800, you know,
yeah,
to get one. It's
oh,
like,
yeah,
if you had a friend that had one, you're like, hey, can I borrow this, man? I want to really play that.
Oh yeah.
And they sounded horrible and everything, you know. But you know, now you've got what, you know, used to be.
You can steal all those programs, man.
Yeah.
Yeah.
If you're good at pirating, yeah, dude.
Multi-million dollar studio one time is now a $150 program you could buy for your laptop with an interface.
Or download like we did.
Yeah, yeah. That. And then just.
You can pirate like crazy.
You can.
It's insane.
Well, that's what's nuts. See that board back there? I got that board for like $50. And how many channels is that? Was that 20? Oh, okay. Yeah, it's a lot.
I teach guitar, so I only count
but
like four.
That
sometimes six.
These mics weren't really that expensive with these. Eight we took the a most. Table, drilled some holes in it. And that's the crazy thing now is everybody has a voice. Mm-hmm. You got the internet now. So if you can find a way to get your face on either, you know, Facebook Live or anything else, everybody has, even if you're a retard and you don't know shit, you have a voice.
That's kind of why I just kind of eventually, after a while, kind of threw my hands up in the air and stopped, you know.
Well, it's because you were posting a bunch of weird shit. Weird love, like Satan holding up a pastor by the throat and said, "You're mine." Oh. And people just lose their shit. And Mike's just back there.
Just trolling.
Yeah.
Just trolling.
Well, I don't know. I guess you had some serious stuff up there or whatever, but you're right. People.
We're talking about social media where you're talking about music. Like, you just kind of like backed off.
Yeah. I just music.
Oh, okay. Music?
Yeah. I think it's talking about music.
Oh, okay.
What are you talking about? I'm like, huh?
I thought you meant like social media.
No.
And people being able to go on and say whatever they wanted, but.
No, yeah. Yeah. I mean, now I'm kind of like at this point in my life, just kind of, you know, making my money, and I want to travel. I want to.
You don't want to sit on your amp for hours at a time like you did back in the day, and just.
No, I do not.
Someday I'll make it.
No, I do not.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So yeah. So what? What keeps you going? If you can't do that anymore, I mean, Mason's part. Have you guys ever heard City and Ashes? Titty and Asses.
Yeah.
Really rad band. They're really good, and even Thera, they're starting up Thera again for all those you guys that you
August 19th.
Willowa.
We said it at the same time. I'm going to be there partying hard.
It's be there without pants.
Yeah, I don't know. It's like, see, that's the whole thing. We're talking about this. Like, it's gotten so much easier to like record music and find music and all that, which it's a blessing and a curse. Yeah. Cause like I've been able to record some like professional music. I'm like, I'm not that great. My band's not, it's good. We're good. Yeah. I'm good, but I'm not like the best. But it's like, I got to record a professional product. That didn't happen, you know?
Yeah.
20 years ago, it was like, you were the best of the best or you got nothing.
Right. So maybe that's like, maybe that's why Faceless was so big. In Alaska, there was nothing.
Maybe.
I have no idea.
Well, it was a time and place.
You guys had a pretty good run. You guys got to tour. You guys went to travel.
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah. It was experience. It was worth it.
Yeah.
Turkey was rad. I don't want to be there right now. I don't know if you guys know what's going on there.
Oh, yeah. Military coup.
Yeah, military coup. They're taking over. And we got boys over there in our base. They're like cut power and water off to them.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh,
starving them out. Yeah, it's not good. No bueno.
Yeah. I was paying attention when that went down. I'm not really sure what's happening now.
As far as now, I mean, that was like yesterday or the day before that I saw about the water and stuff. I have no idea what's going on now. They might be getting taken care of. I don't know. Maybe someone's going there and helping them out. Pray for our boys in green. Or tan. Is it tan? Probably desert. Probably tan.
Yeah, desert tan.
Yeah.
Desert
no, but that was cool because we are actually at that base, Ingerlik. And it was pretty sweet base. Feel sorry for those dudes over there. But. Yeah, but yeah, nowadays with music, man,
it's nothing really to really work towards. I mean, you know, growing up, you know, listening to my favorite bands, you know, it was kind of like something you were like, oh, I want to attain to that. I want to become that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they were bigger than life. You know, it's just like, now you don't really have that. I don't know. It's just.
Do you think the, like, not the Voice, but yeah, the Voice or America's Got Talent or Britain's Got Talent. You think they kind of stole some of that? I mean, there's this kind of.
Obviously looking for a certain kind of formula, you know. I mean,
it makes me sick. I like every once in a while I'll see something special, like that's cool, that's shared on Facebook, like for the Voice or something like that. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, wow, this person's really talented and all this other stuff. And it almost seems like you can't make it unless you're in some kind of that kind of platform.
Mm-hmm.
Hunger Games.
Yeah. Whoa. That's deep.
For music.
Hunger Game for music.
Yeah.
There you go.
Yeah. I don't know. And you're never going to see a metal band up there, a rock band playing either.
No, but then they got to fit a certain kind of, you know, predetermined, you know, formula or mold or whatever that they're expecting. You know, you can't be. What pisses me off is, like, if you really think about it, you know, legends like Johnny Cash or Elvis, if the same people that we know of, you know, from 50 years ago or whatever, were take that person and put them in one of those shows, they would not make it.
You're right. Yeah, and you know, you're right.
Because they were either too old or didn't have the look or their sound
too drunk.
You know, but I mean,
truth.
Elvis could have made it. Elvis was a performer. Cash, I don't know. Cash is a bit of Cash was raw.
Yeah, I
but
know.
Elvis,
but
Elvis, when he was young, he was good looking. Like, you know, he could have made it. But maybe. Johnny Cash
was never good looking.
No,
he was always rough.
Yeah,
yeah.
But I'm just saying, you know, that put him into the situation.
Oh, sure.
With the formula, what they're looking for,
or like Bob Dylan.
Bob Dylan.
Oh God.
Oh yeah.
Bob Dylan's like he's not. That's the other thing about those shows.
I don't understand Bob.
You don't either.
What did he just say? Maybe like two songs. Three.
I like that cover that Jimi Hendrix did of his song. Yeah. All of us. That's amazing.
Good job, Bob Dylan.
Best song.
/ Jimi Hendrix.
Did you ever see Walk Hard?
No.
Oh, Dewey Cox.
Yeah.
Story.
Oh, yeah.
When he like
you don't want no part of the shit, Dewey.
Yeah. What are you guys doing in here? Cocaine.
What's that?
It turns all your bad feelings into good feelings. It's a nightmare. I think I want some of that cocaine. You haven't seen that?
No.
No. There. He goes through all these phases.
Do you know my wife? She's like, well, I don't know about that. Is that going to make me feel good or bad?
It'll probably make you feel good.
No, no.
Well, have you seen
that
Walk
kind of humor? She's like,
oh,
she's
yeah.
Have you seen Walk the Line, though? Johnny Cash?
No, yeah. I want to watch that. She's like, oh, it's too sad.
Like, oh,
yeah, it was good.
That's a great movie.
That's
a great
movie.
Yeah, Joaquin Phoenix. Biopic. How about Ray?
Oh, that was a great movie.
I haven't
too.
Seen Ray.
Oh,
I need
wow.
to.
Really good.
Okay. Really good.
That and, what's it called? By James Brown.
Ooh, James Brown.
I heard of that.
James Brown. Oh, I did.
There's a biopic about
it. Get on up.
I think I'm good. Get on up.
Living in America is my go-to.
Oh yeah,
like living finishing America. Karaoke song. Work.
Oh really?
At the end of the night.
Hell yeah. Well, it's funny.
I won a contest at Homies years ago
for singing that one. Living in America. Oh my gosh! Did you sing it like him?
Yeah.
Or
well, I did my.
Well, I mean, it wasn't
I
your
did
own
my
flame.
Darndest.
Anything with America in it, with a bunch of drunk people out in the middle of nowhere, is gonna vote for you.
Well, yeah, no.
America, he's a winner.
That was that song. That song was on the Rocky IV soundtrack.
Yeah.
And so I had that. I had that cassette and
working out.
That's pretty much all I listened to, and I still listen to it today.
And do what's on fire, strong desire. He's like, what is this?
Oh my God, dude!
I know, Living in America.
Oh man, Vince DiCola actually composed like the orchestral kind of synth stuff to it, and he also did the first Transformers movie one. He asked to do.
I'm running up a mountain. I'm getting in shape. Oh. Abs.
Yo, I'm gonna go pull a tractor out of Russia.
Oh, that was awesome. Best movie ever.
He's like going around like handing out loaves of bread and
That's hilarious working how like pure America was in Russia while that damn Russian was shooting up working in this high tech.
He had treadmills.
Yeah.
What is that?
He had roids.
Cheater. He had roids, right in the shoulder. You don't shoot your roids in the shoulder. That's the worst place to do it.
That's why he lost.
No yes, Americans.
Rock kept hitting him in the shoulder.
Yeah.
Does it hurt? Ow. Does it hurt?
I think he lost because Rocky was too short and he couldn't like actually.
Oh
like,
yeah. Oh, he was getting beat there for a while. Wow. He's like a piece of iron. This fast move off. Oh man, horrible movie. Great movie, best movie, but horrible. Horrible movie when you go back and watch it again, and then there's still like that kid in you that just loves it. You start to feel awesome. Warm inside. You're like, man, I could do this. It doesn't matter what you're doing. You could be butter and toast. I'm going to blur it down. Yeah. This is cool.
Hot song. I got this.
That was the 80s, man. That was great.
Oh, yeah.
I'm pretty sure that I have this on Spotify, like, saved to the phone.
So whenever you need that motivation.
Just don't play too much of it.
Rocky IV, original.
Survivor, man.
Original soundtrack.
It's there. I got the soundtrack.
Oh, you do.
Downloaded on my phone.
Shoot, that's rad. Oh, it was life is just a fantasy. Can you live this fantasy? That's the cover they did. Steel Panther. This came to me.
20 minutes later.
City lights. Yeah, come on. You don't know the song?
Nope.
Are you kidding me?
It's not ringing a bell.
Oh, my gosh.
It's not ringing a bell.
You can look up lyrics, so yeah.
Yeah, you can.
Life is just a fantasy.
You know what I'm talking about, though. What? Oh, my God. I think we might actually be able to play it because it's a cover.
You can play
covers
it.
So many seconds. Domain, man.
Are covers okay? You can do that?
This is a recording of a cover of a.
Well, yeah.
For certain purposes,
for
discussion purposes, you can play it.
Right.
So, yeah.
If it's too. If it's too long and stuff, they can, like, YouTube can cut you out.
Right.
Like, I'm not. Yeah. So, I mean,
I'm pretty sure that band's not going to be like, whoa.
I'm sure they won't. But, I don't know.
Shut these guys down.
Glory hole.
Not for music.
Death to All But Metal Live.
I like that song.
Death to All But.
The video.
Oh, Death. Is Death to All But Metal? No, it's Death to All But Metal.
Yeah. Death to All
But
Metal. One T. But Metal.
Wait. One T or two T's? That's the question.
What
kind of butts we're talking about? Huh?
Butt rock.
Which one?
Remember that term, butt rock?
Yeah.
Oh yeah,
but that's a really broad term. Like
I know,
like it used. I don't know. Like who's that pertain to now? Butt rock. It used to be like.
I don't think there's any
hair
dude.
Metal.
Yeah, that was like hair metal was butt rock. Now it's like
because of the tight jeans.
Is it just whatever's like mainstream? Is that butt rock or is that definitely just hair metal?
I remember it used to just be referring to like hair metal or 80s metal.
Okay,
you know because of the tight pants.
See when I. That kind of pertained to like Nickelback and Creed and stuff.
Ooh.
When I cause kind of just like the radio just
gross
the Yarler kind of you know the post grunge thing. That's kind of what butt rock was to me.
That's,
I think
that
it kinda,
actually would have been a more accurate. I would have put that title towards the bands like that.
Yeah. You know? Yeah, well, they kind of took that place.
Yeah.
Like of like you know, 80s crack. 80s like glam metal, like you kind of that wave of like, yeah, whatever, the Nickelback, Creed, Seether, yeah, Stain thing. They all just kind of adopted like, we're Nickelback, all doing this sound.
So yeah, rad.
And just like, it was super popular and kind of shallow. It's just not awesome. So, you know, I think it applies. It's like butt rock in each generation.
Nickelback pissed me off with that one song where they're like, we're all going to stay skinny because we just won't eat.
Yeah.
And then like right after that, they talk about eating tacos. It's just like a double, like you just said you don't eat. How do you lose?
That's the beef you have inside. It's just, like, whoa,
it kept me up one night.
I've got other beef.
Incongruent.
Oh, I do too. I just don't want to be too hard on them because actually, because
you love them.
And dude, a side of a bullet is pretty rad. Okay,
of a bullet.
Oh, wait, are you talking about Creed?
No.
No, this is Nickelback, son. Nickelback. This is Nickelback, son.
Oh, Creed has a bullet song, too.
Dude. Oh, yeah.
Speaking of Creed.
Up to my head. Shoot the bullet through my head. That's a sweet riff. Through my head.
That is Tremonti. Yeah. Tremonti is a legend. He just is a straight legend, dude. I respect that, dude. But
The lead singer went nuts. Scott.
He sang it. Okay, Scott, I gotta look this
he
up.
He
was on stage with A Day to Remember.
Like recently?
He was. I was gonna bring that up.
I just saw that. I was like,
he was homeless too. He was living out of college.
There's some videos going around. I was like, bro.
They recorded him. He called the school and like tried to get his kid out of there, said the FBI is watching him, and like he was just acting all nutty.
There's a bunch of videos of like him this close to his phone. He's like, hey guys, how's it going? Stapp here. And just so you know, if you see any helicopters.
Is this that cover? You finally found it? Half hour later. Oh, nice.
You don't remember this at all?
It sounds familiar. Hold on.
Oh, man, the vibrato on that line.
Oh, man, that's sick.
I don't know what the original is.
Oh my god.
So sick. The Def Leppard backing vocals. I love it.
Here you go. Oh, orgasm, dude. I'm telling you. That song right there, that cover. It like is probably my favorite cover in the world. They even sing Journey.
What's the original?
Better than
though?
Journey.
Yeah.
To me. I was like,
okay.
I would do music like that.
I feel tougher after listening to that.
Yeah. Don't you? Dude, it makes me just want to like, I don't know, start doing blow and grow my hair out. ride a bicycle with no shirt on after I lost a bunch of weight.
Ride a motorcycle.
You know.
A bunch of blow, you will lose a bunch of
weight. It's
how it works.
I'm back on the wagon. And I'm very proud of Mike. He has lost a bunch. Look at him. Looks fantastic.
I thought you were talking about Coke. I was like,
no.
You're on Coke now?
No, wait. Yeah. No, I'm back on the wagon.
Yeah, you're looking better.
No, I'm not. No, I'm saying he's like, this guy has transformed himself.
I said that when he walked in. I was like, bro, you look good.
Yeah. It's amazing. You're still going. And I don't know. That's something with musicians, except for me. Oh, because you guys are in pretty good shape, too. He rides his bike and runs everywhere.
Yeah.
You run everywhere. Up mountains anyway.
Yeah, I do the occasional. Like, dude, it's the first time this ever happened to me. I'm probably not in the greatest shape right now. Probably the worst I've been in the last like 3 years. I threw up on a hike the other day.
That's because you were hungover.
Did I tell you about this?
Yes.
Yeah, I went hiking
go ahead.
With Adam Rush. I wasn't hungover, but it was 4th of July.
I just had a couple drinks the night before. What did you drink?
It was
how many?
4th of July. Well, we stayed about 1:30. I probably had 4 or 5 beers. No, nothing ridiculous. Between like 11.
What kind of beers?
IPA, 8.5% alcohol.
That's not that ridiculous. 4 or 5. Anyway.
4 or 5.
On the 3rd of July, you know, midnight, you know, we're hanging out, watching the fireworks. And he's like, we're going to go hiking tomorrow. But he had like other plans that afternoon. So we got up at 6 o'clock. He's at my house like 6:30. And I'm like,
what
I hate you. But I did it. I did it because I'm not a bitch.
Wait, so was he out there with you the night before?
He was, and he smoked me, dude. He's carrying a pack, and
you
like
didn't bring Band-Aid beers or anything like that.
Yeah, no, you got to do that.
No, just some water.
Especially for when you get a thought.
So we did Wolverine. It's like Anchorage Bowl Peak. I don't know. It's probably like 4 or 5 miles, and like we get about a mile or two in, and just had straight diarrhea. Just like go off into the woods. I was just like, I gotta go. I like, I don't feel okay at all. Like I felt terrible. So I got that out of the way. I'm like, okay, I'm good. Keep going up further. Get most probably about 2/3 of the way there, and I'm just like, I'm just nauseated while hiking. Like I keep stopping, just like waves are just like, bleh. And I just I can't fight anymore. Like 200 yards from like the ridge line, just chucked on a mountain. So I lost it both ends hiking Fourth of July. So I learned a little something about myself. I just no sleep, and just a bunch of beer in the gut. Like it's bad. It's bad, dude.
How old are you, Mason?
28.
Okay.
Oh my God, you're a baby.
Yeah.
Dude, I went hiking on Sunday. When I can't even remember the place. So it's at the very end of It's at the very end of Highland. You know Highland Road when you go up in between the mountains.
Oh yeah, Symphony Lake.
Yeah.
You go up.
So instead of Symphony, but the
there's
trail.
Hunter Pass, and then there's Rendezvous Point.
It's Hunter's Pass.
Yeah, yeah.
So we climbed up there, and
into the little buck yep. back. Yeah.
And the lady, a girl that went with us, actually asked us to go. Had a newborn on her chest.
Yeah.
Carrying a 4-year-old on her back.
Oh wow.
And she's like, this big. She's small.
Yeah.
And she's like, come on, everybody. And dude, I was like, oh my God, this girl's
just
putting
smoking,
me to shame. Yeah.
I
was going to vomit and I didn't even drink. No, I was okay. Yeah. We made it. So I don't know. You still hiking stuff?
Yeah. Yeah. We're in Utah last week visiting family and they took us up Park
City.
Take
pee break.
Out,
speaking of bodily functions.
Oh. Just go out there. Just go out there and pee on the fence to the left. Facing the road.
So we were hiking and like the altitude was crushing me because we were up like 9,000 feet, like just already just starting, and so my lungs were like this big.
Itty bitty.
My brother took me on this bike ride where we did 19 miles, 2,200 elevation gain, and cracked 9,000 feet. And by like the time like the last hill, which was called Puke Hill, to get on top of this ridge, I was just like, I'm gonna hoof it. I was just like pushing. I was pushing my bike, and just kind of like my head was like swimming.
Swooshy.
You know? It was like butterflies would go past me, and I'd just be like,
"Oh, check it out!"
Oh, yeah, whoa, and almost fall down. You know,
how were you good for the ride down?
We stayed up there and like ate a bunch of snacks and stuff, and like
felt better,
climatized. You know,
oh, that's
then,
good.
And then came down, but I took it super slow on the way down.
Dude, that stuff's that's crazy that your body can be affected like that from altitude.
Yeah,
I mean
it's
nuts. You too? You hiking?
No, I just paint.
You're like, I get my lung restriction through fumes. You feel better?
I feel better now.
Oh,
I was sweating holding that.
Yeah, you can pee whenever you want, man.
Okay.
Yeah, don't worry about it. You guys, if you guys want to pee, it's out there to the left on the fence or whatever.
Yeah, sweet.
Yeah. No, he was telling me about how he was hiking in Utah and his lungs were all closing off.
Yeah.
Altitude.
Which is weird.
9,000 feet.
Utah.
Yeah.
So you were on the
like 500
east side of Utah or whatever?
Salt Lake, and then you hit all the the resorts from there, Park City, Alta Snowbird, and stuff like that.
It's beautiful there, though, right?
It's amazing. It's like
you want to move there now, don't you? Can I have one of those? Or is
I
that
don't
a,
know, man.
Yeah,
it's
he has one mind.
That's around.
There's a lot of good food, you know. The foodie in me was like, I don't want to go back to Alaska because it seems like a desert wasteland of food compared to this place. The restaurants were amazing.
Yeah.
So. Like Vegas.
Yeah.
I stopped by, whenever I used to go up the 15, yeah. I'd stop by.
Ooh, the 15.
Yeah.
Man.
I'd actually stop by Salt Lake just just rest.
Yeah.
You know, take a little stretch of legs and everything. A lot of good looking women there.
Yeah.
Like, I would actually follow some of them on the streets.
Mike was creeping.
I thought you were like, follow on
hey,
Facebook.
Baby.
I was like, oh, no, this is before that time.
Hey, baby. This is binoculars.
Stalking the Mormon chicks, man.
Do you know some places in Utah, it's illegal.
A missionary position. No. Come on. Really,
it's
girl?
Some
2-year missionary position.
Some places there, it's so illegal to stand with your beer. Like, you're not allowed to stand up with your beer.
Some crazy laws. Like,
yeah.
If you
can't, right, cocktails, like, they can't, you have to mix it yourself, right?
What?
No.
That's what I heard. Maybe it's not that way anymore.
If you ask for a floater, then, or an extra shot or anything, then.
Normally, you don't want floaters in your drink. No, what are you talking about?
A floater, a shot. Can I get a floater, a rum? Or
oh, okay.
Like that? And so, but no, they, any of the draft beer there, anything on tap has to be 4% or less.
Really?
Whoa.
So like no all matter, the good
even
beer.
If, even if you are your own brewery and anything. And but anything
4%? That's
you're talking
bad,
about
dude.
Even if you brew at your own house?
Oh, no, this is 5.7
right
here. 5.7.
This is restaurants. If you like restaurants can carry bottles and have any percentage that they want.
Draft has to be 4%.
And then all beer in all of their there's no refrigerators in their liquor store.
There's zero. Warm beer? You got to cool it off when you get home.
And only things that have alcohol in them are in liquor stores. There's no ice. There's no mixers. There's no anything.
What?
Yeah.
Whoa. And that's when you said, yeah, it's a Alaska's a food desert. You know, but
we got beer, son.
But the beer flows
we got
like
booze.
Honey.
I know. Oh, or if you go to a brewery and you want to have tasters, they have to have like a food license. You have to order an entree. And
what if you don't want to eat? What if you're not hungry?
No, you have to do that.
You have to eat.
Yeah, you just bring. Like,
they don't want you drinking.
You just bring your fat friend. We'll order two beers. I'll eat the food, and then you can drink the beer. I like it.
It's
wait, you're saying Alaska is a food desert? Are you talking about Michelle Obama type food desert?
What? Yeah. No. Or not like that. I was just talking about like
because the produce here sucks.
All the restaurants were just super good. They were just. You know, like a cut above. Well, not all of them, but the ones that we went to and we found out about. It's like there's no just places quality. Like this in Alaska that are inventive, that are making these flavors happen, that are doing their own thing from scratch, kind of thing. There's not everybody's just bringing up like frozen shit and then
there is one eating. Place,
well,
isn't there?
Well, there are places that do that in Alaska, but it's I mean, compared you gotta, to the options,
you
go
find
have,
it, right? You hunt
yeah,
down.
Like Jack Sprat, boom,
yeah,
amazing in. Alaska.
Right.
Yeah.
Or was it Chair...
Chair 6?
Is it Chair...
Chair 6 is pricey. Chair that's the one up on... Wait, Chair 7?
I don't know.
Did you go to Tequila?
The one that's at the top at Alyeska. Yeah.
Tequila
nice
61?
Spot.
Is that...
I haven't been there yet. I walked in there before it was
do
open.
Do they have tequila?
I loved it. They
okay.
Do.
They got to.
When,
they got
see,
to.
When they first were coming out and they're like, hey, we're going to be a restaurant. They're like, we serve beer and wine. And I was like... But your name's Tequila.
But
written off.
Oh no.
So
no
have
food,
you been there?
The food is amazing. I went there for dinner one time.
I got a tour of the place before
tequila.
It was open. Okay.
I didn't order tequila, but I did order. But they have hard alcohol.
Okay. All right.
So I'm assuming tequila would be right next to some
maybe. You know,
Jameson
I wonder if
I
they didn't
drinking.
Have their liquor license quite yet. But
that
they
could
had
be
it. Like whatever the okay. beer license. Yeah. That might have been the thing.
Okay.
So
well, actually, me and Chris I'll went for his there. Birthday and go there. Word. They have these tacos like that are like they're like four mini tacos.
Yeah.
For an appetizer, get that and then get an entree. And, oh my god,
sounds good.
They're so good. I can't. I mean, and it's like the fancy shit too. You know, they bring you this bowl and you're like, what is this? Never seen this before. And you taste it and you're like, ooh, flavor from like ten different
from all angles.
Yeah, it's amazing.
I'm going there.
Do it that place, and I've never been to the other place you were talking about. Jack Sprat. I've never been there.
It's a Girdwood, and
oh wait,
it's awesome.
Is that the breakfast joint?
They got breakfast.
Is it the little brunch. Like?
Yeah.
I did eat there. That was really good.
Yam fries.
I didn't have the fries.
Oh dude.
Yam fries.
Yeah.
What?
Yam fries and it's like green garlic whatever aioli
ooh.
Sauce.
I like.
It's good.
I like.
Yeah.
Mm. Hey, did you?
Really hungry. No.
So Utah, did you guys go to Allison Chains? We were
no.
talking about it. Oh, you didn't.
Nah, my
just didn't my, just didn't work out.
My brother is at a place where he's just kind of like, he didn't feel like he could do it, you know, and he didn't really want to go out and stuff.
Right, right.
And then I didn't
so
really,
you say,
I didn't
screw
want,
you, brother.
Yeah, I didn't want to go alone, you know. I didn't want to take.
Oh, like, Amanda didn't want to go?
No.
She didn't want to go see some Alice in Chains? What's wrong with that girl?
I wouldn't want to go see Alice in Chains with Amanda.
Aww.
Wait, okay, now listen. See. Look, I've known Amanda longer than you have.
Yeah, yeah.
And. But you know her way better than I do, for sure. But
I'd hope so.
Yeah. They've only had sex a bunch.
Weird.
They're married, by the way. So she's not like at all like bending to do.
Oh no, she like, would. She would.
She would.
She totally would have gone.
Right.
But
she would have been a good sport, but it's not her thing.
Yeah.
Because like
that
puts
that
up
band.
With a lot.
Yeah.
I mean, no. No, not with just you. I'm just saying, like growing up, it was like, you know, if anything that she either didn't want to do or. You know, whatever she'd appease people. She's that.
Yeah.
She's the kind of person that's, you know. Yeah.
She totally would have gone.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Totally cool. Would have gone. But also, we flew all night.
God, thanks for a bitch.
Yeah. We flew all night. We didn't sleep. Then we went on a hike, and then we're like out the whole day, and then we're just like, Eric doesn't really want to go, blah blah blah. Let's just go to sleep.
So, oh, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. If I had been there, Kyle, if you invited me along,
we would have gone. Next time you and I are gonna go visit my family, forget Amanda.
It's gonna be awesome to see a bunch of rock shows in Salt Lake City.
What do you got going on over there, Mike?
I got the whole gang here.
You do.
So when that tauntaun got cut open, spoiler alert if you haven't seen it. No.
Spoiler alert from like 4 years later. I thought it smelled bad on the outside.
So when I was a kid, I remember watching that at home, and I was eating a banana. And it got cut open.
Associated.
It got cut open, and I was like, it looked like this like banana barf, like, and I was like, sick to my stomach, just almost lost it. And for years, I just couldn't watch it. Even today, I'm just kind of like,
can you eat bananas though?
Bananas are fine.
Okay. You just can't watch that scene.
Tauntaun guts.
It always looked like really big, like Link sausages.
Do you guys see the
eat a banana and watch it next time? Bite that you're up.
Do you guys see the Revenant?
Yeah,
Leo. Mm-hmm. They totally ripped off that scene, dude.
Oh, they did.
He cuts open a horse and sleeps inside it.
Yeah,
stay warm. I was like, where's the line? Is he gonna say it?
But that actually happened. Yeah, he crawled in there.
Allegedly.
Like, yeah, it's not bad.
On the outside. Dude, I would have cracked up if they put that in.
But
Leo,
guess
like,
what?
Straight face. There would smell bad on the outside.
There would have went his Oscar. It would have been gone.
Right.
Yeah, right.
He'd have been like, yeah, it was great all the way up until he started quoting Luke Skywalker.
Right.
I mean, yeah.
No, I would have been sold, dude. Because I was stoked on the movie.
Han, damn it.
I was
stoked. Dislike. Oh, that's so funny because I've done that to people.
I was stoked on that movie for about a half hour, and then I got real bored. So I would have picked up like
of The Empire Strikes Back.
No, of The Revenant.
I was like, you're not friends with me anymore.
You're dumb.
Empire Strikes Back is probably of the old trilogy. It's probably my least favorite.
Really?
And I know that's the complete opposite of everybody, but I've always been like,
what's your favorite?
I like Return of the Jedi.
Return of the Jedi.
Yeah.
Return of the Jedi is rad, dude.
Ewoks.
That's the first one.
Yeah.
Ewoks.
Dude, all the stuff between like Darth and Luke at the end there, that's like, it's good.
Yeah.
Like, that's like some deep shit.
Yeah, it
like,
is some deep stuff.
Oh, yeah.
Like,
yeah.
It gets to you. Yeah. I like that one.
Yeah.
I still think Snoke is Darth Vader.
On all.
Just saying.
Really?
Yeah,
Anakin's
man.
Darth,
a lot of people say
about?
He might.
Oh, he's gonna be the new Darth Vader.
No,
they say he might be actually Darth Plagueis.
Well, but you look at the picture between Snoke and Darth Vader, or Anakin Skywalker after he takes off his helmet, he's got the huge scar on his face.
He's not actually dead. He's like a hologram now.
No, I don't think he's a hologram. I think actually they burnt his body. He got all disfigured like that.
Again?
No, like at the end of Return of the Jedi. And then he got possessed by Darth's Plagueis. And so he's using his body. That's what I think. That's just what I'm saying.
What?
How do you survive?
I don't even understand that.
His helmet survived. And
badly.
But look at Snoke. I'm saying like a little bit of alien reconstruction or midichlorian reconstruction. Boom. New body.
Well,
I'm just saying.
Theory. That's a theory.
Who's
theory.
Darth Plagueis?
He's the
wait, remember now, Plagueis had all his limbs too, like organic limbs.
But what I'm saying is,
I don't even know this Darth Plagueis.
He probably possessed Darth.
This is some of that extracurricular.
Plagueis.
Sorry,
if you don't know what we're talking about,
you're an idiot.
Plagueis he was master to Palpatine.
Okay.
So
this is some of that. Extended universe. I was gonna say extracurricular. It's not it. Extended
this is
universe.
Star Wars lore.
Right.
Yeah.
Back up, bitch.
I bow to your authority. I haven't studied up on my extended universe.
It's just
because
we're
knowledge.
Old.
Right.
That's the only reason why. And actually,
dude, my little bros, they're into it too because they watch like the cartoons and stuff.
Yeah,
and
I
like
watch the cartoons.
Yeah, I was at because he's all about it. So I'm like, hey, who's your favorite Star Wars character? He's like, blah 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 blah. I'm like,
who is that?
He's not in any of the movies. He's like a clone trooper from the cartoons.
Yeah.
He's kind of badass.
Well, see,
I was like. Really? Bro, that's extended universe. That doesn't even like. That's
no, no,
not,
no.
Is it's that
not,
canon?
It's not really. Like
I tried
all that.
I tried
it's
to.
Canon now, yeah.
Oh, it is. Now. All of I tried that. To explain to him, like, that's not really canon. And he was like, what are you talking about? Oh. He didn't really get that concept, but I guess maybe I'm wrong. It is canon.
Those cartoons and stuff are like all in line, like. Yeah. With the series right. and everything else, and yeah. if
it's
you
canon.
Miss out on those cartoons, then you're kind of lost. That the
I guess that's kind out. Of an advantage for Disney taking it over because the
hey Rockstar, that's Whitney. Say hi, what's Whitney.
Up? Hello.
That's Titty's wife, Chris's wife.
Chris,
I don't know. You, yeah, have you met Chris Titty?
Maybe not.
Maybe not. I don't think yeah. so. Yeah. Well, cool.
We're in his garage, so
yeah.
Thank you, Chris.
Thanks, Chris. Thanks, Whitney.
Rest in peace.
Oh, we totally blocked her parking spot, too. So let me know afterwards. I'll pull your car in if you want. She's going to take me up on it, too. I would. You're going to do it because you parked in her spot.
Oh, well, you didn't sell me.
I know. I just was like, I'll do it later.
What's that?
As long as that bike's out of here.
Oh, yeah.
No, I'll just run over that. Just
I'm actually gonna crash on that mat over there.
Yeah, can we stay the night? We've had too much.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. The couch is already taken. Oh, okay. Thanks, Whitney.
Right down touché. One spot. Ouch.
See you. Yeah, cray cray. Well, we're almost at an hour. Mm. Anybody want to say anything before they peace out? A little ad, a little nod.
I'm good, man.
That's it.
It's a nice day.
It is a nice day. Thanks, guys, for coming on.
Yeah.
Cheers.
Peace.
Peace.